Yeah, hello, I'm Oleg Tscheltzoff. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Fotolia.com. So Fotolia is a leading marketplace for stock photography. So anybody who needs images for illustration purposes can come to the website and would find all sorts of images. We like to call ourselves the world's local image because we have photographers from nearly all the countries of the world representing all types of thematics. So so people come to the website and license stock photography for as low as $1 per image.
At a conference like this, what is your main role? Are you here more as the CEO of Fotolia looking maybe for investment, or are you the investor who looks for new startups?
Well, Fotolia is a big company, so we're not really looking for investments. We have over 100 million of revenue per year. But obviously I come here because we're always searching for deals, you know, for the company, biz dev, do partnerships, I mean, with different companies, people who needs indirectly stock photography. But also personally, I'm an investor, quite active angel investor in France and in Europe, in Germany also a lot, in the UK. I have over 40 investments currently running, so I always like to look at new startups and new ideas and help new entrepreneurs to launch their ventures.
Are there any special markets or segments that you're interested in?
Well, I love marketplaces. It's not always easy to start, but when you have built a marketplace, Fotolia is typically a marketplace, crowdsource marketplace, where on the one side you have many photographers and on the other side buyers, and everybody holds each other. So this type of marketplaces I really love, and I like to invest in them. And then a part of that, I mean, I think it's a lot about teams, you know, people who are passionate about what they're doing and who need the initial help and a little bit of experience also sharing.
Yesterday, Wunderlist announced that they raised $19 million from Sequoia Capital, and a week before that, Twitter went public. How would you rate the current climate for startups and maybe also with a special perspective on Germany?
Well, I think there is a lot of money in the markets right now. I mean, we have seen that the markets are extremely bullish about companies who go IPO. So for good companies, I mean, good teams, it's really a good time, I mean, to raise money and to start businesses. But on the other side, competition is also very, very hard because all this gives a lot of ideas, of course, and envy, I would say, to many entrepreneurs to launch their business. So competition is hard, so you need to have really good teams, good ideas, and try to execute as fast as possible and as perfectly as you can.
Okay. How would you rate a good, strong team? What are the characteristics that you're looking for?
Well, a good strong team for me, it's few co-founders because I think it's a long journey, I mean, to build a startup, so I like teams of two, three people. Complementary teams, so preferably somebody who is a technical person, like a CTO, you know, and a biz dev person, and maybe a creative person. I think the creative aspect is more and more important, the UI, UX, also somebody who really understands, I mean, people navigate, you know, these type of services. And then people who are not necessarily only coming out from business schools, because today, usually before, you know, people graduating for the best business schools were going to work for big corporations. Today, the dream of everybody is doing startups. But I like also teams of people who come from a certain industry, have experience, you know, on that field, you know, and who go and build something, you know, from their real world. I mean, for example, I don't know, just as an example, you know, it could be a cook, you know, doing something about cooking, you know, online, or people, you know, who have really, really some experience about the field.
Great. Thanks a lot for your time and enjoy the rest of the conference.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you.